In this demo, I'll show you how the metadata deployment flow works in Gearset. If you're used to change sets, you'll find Gearset much faster and more reliable. I can compare Git repositories and scratch orgs with Gearset, and in this video, I'm going to run a comparison between my dev sandbox and my UAT org. Clicking Compare Now starts the comparison. And what's happening behind the scenes here is Gearset using Salesforce's metadata API to pull down all the metadata from my orgs. So that's all the configuration and code in my org, from objects, Apex, Process Builder to profiles. You can see it moving through each step as Gearset talks to Salesforce, downloading, caching, and comparing metadata. So this is Gearset's comparison viewer. It's a semantic diff displaying changed, new, and deleted items. Looking in new, I can see that there's a new discount percentage field on the account object, which I'll select for deployment. Clicking the dropdown on this object shows it's dependent on the discount rate field, which is also new. But let's say I've forgotten to include this dependency and leave the box unchecked so discount rate won't be included. We'll see how Gearset handles a missing dependency in this deployment. Now let's check out the deleted items. Unlike change sets, Gearset supports destructive changes. There's one item here that's in my target org, but not in my source. I'll check this box so it's deleted in the deployment. Looking in changed items, I can see anything that's changed between my target and my source. Checking this box at the top selects all items to deploy all the changes. And Gearset shows me a visual comparison of the differences in each field, providing a breakdown of the exact differences as an object view, pick list, or XML, making it easy to spot changes in my metadata. I could save a draft of my deployment at this stage, but I'm going to run it. Now I can see that Gearset's found a problem with my deployment, and it's suggested a fix. Gearset has over 50 problem analyzers that trigger if something in your deployment might make it fail. Gearset really does the heavy lifting here, so it's easy to fix deployment issues before you deploy without doing any extra work. Gearset can see that I have a missing dependency, which is that discount rate field that I forgot to include at the start, and suggests including the missing component. If I check these boxes, it will resolve the issue. On this screen, Gearset summarizes what's included in my deployment. I need to give the deployment a name and also write a summary of what I did. This all goes in my deployment history, so it's easy to look back and understand what a deployment included and get some context about it, which is helpful if you're working in a team and all making changes to orgs. Now, I could deploy right away, but it's better safe than sorry, so I'll get Salesforce to validate my changes first, from within Gearset. Here, you can see Gearset talking to Salesforce, validating each component in the deployment to be sure that it can run. And everything's gone green, so it looks like we're all good to go. If this were a deployment to a live environment, I'd prefer to deploy outside of working hours. Fortunately, Gearset won't let me schedule this deployment ahead of time to minimise disruption, so I'll schedule it for next Friday evening at 3:30 in the morning, when hopefully nobody's at work, and I'll even get Gearset to email me a notification. So I could schedule my deployment like that, but let's deploy for real now to see how easy it is to deploy with Gearset. So I'll just click Deploy Now, and what's happening is Gearset is uploading the final deployment package to Salesforce, and we'll use Quick Deploy to apply the previously validated package if it's available. And here we are, Gearset has successfully run the deployment. So in just a few minutes, I compared my orgs, built a deployment package, and deployed it. It's that straightforward, and Gearset can save you hours of work when you're free from things like manually moving profiles across, or pushing entire profiles for just the new field. And that's all for this demo. Take a look around the site and sign up for a free trial to see how Gearset could help you. No payment details are needed to sign up, and Gearset is a web app, so there's nothing to install locally or in your orgs. If you have a question, please feel free to email us or get in touch through the in-app chat. Thank you for watching.